Good day. I am going to talk about urinary stone disease, which is otherwise kidney stone disease, which is becoming more common compared to before because of various reasons. I am seeing patients between 20 to 50 years commonly with stone problem, even though we have children coming from 2 years onwards, infants coming from 6 months onwards with stone problem. Even the elderly age group people of 80, 85 year old with stone disease, I have been treating. The common reason for stone disease are related to where we live, what we eat, and how much water consumption we take in our regular day-to-day life. When you take less amount of water and live in a temperate climate, eat a lot of non-vegetarian food and eat a lot of salt in our food, you tend to form stone disease. And a common problem we face with stone disease are they can be silent in less number of people. There will be a big population coming with severe pain, vomiting, abdominal discomfort, and they will be withering in pain. They will not be able to sit or stand. It will be even in older days, they used to quote, the pain will be more severe than pain because of delivery. So, when they come into the hospital, first thing they need to do is have a good painkiller. Then you will have to do some investigation on them. What are the tests we commonly do for the stone disease patients are, they will have to undergo a single test, which is most often will clench the diagnosis, and the treatment option also given based on that test, which is CT scan of the kidney, ureter and bladder. Before we do the test, we completely examine the patient to rule out some other cause for the pain, which will be like any abdominal problem, any chest problem can present as pain in the abdomen. And these age group people are working population where most often they will be fit, they suddenly develop the pain. And when you do a CT scan, you will be identifying where is the stone, whether it is in the kidneys or in the ureter or in the urinary bladder. Based on the size, location and significant or insignificant obstruction it creates to the urinary system, treatment option varies. Commonly, stones less than 6 millimeter anywhere in the urinary tract are medically managed unless patient present with severe intolerable pain, vomiting persistent and fever and abnormal renal function. When they present with these conditions, they need to have an intervention as soon as possible. Otherwise, the renal function will be affected and the patient will land up in more complications. And what are the treatment options available for stone disease? The commonest first line of management for stone disease up to 6 to 7 millimeter in the urinary tract is medical management, painkiller, and there is a newer therapy available which is called medical expulsive therapy, where you give some medicines to expel the stone. Unlike the common belief where people think the stone can be disintegrated or they make it disappear through the system is not possible. Patient need to expel the stone even it is 3 millimeter to 7 millimeter or 8 millimeter. Commonly, women tend to expel stone size bigger than men. That is a common practice we see, most probably because women tolerate pain better and the ureters are a little pliable than men. And what are the treatment options available? If the stones in the kidney, if they are very small, between 5 to 10 millimeter of size, and they are not causing symptom, and up to 7 millimeter, they can be medically observed if they are not having any symptoms. But patient has symptoms more than 5 millimeter stone, they need to undergo treatment. The treatment options can be breaking from outside, which is otherwise called extracorporeal lithotripsy. The other options are retrograde intrarenal surgery, where the stones in the kidney can be accessed through the urinary tract through a flexible ureteroscope, where you can go and see the stone through the flexible ureteroscope and use a holmium laser to break it into smaller bits. Sometimes you can remove it through a basket also. This can be possible up to 2 cm size stone in the kidney. And stones which are beyond 2 cm, most often they are managed by percutaneous method. It is nothing but you make a small hole through the back, which is approximately 0.5 cm to 1 cm through the hole. You go into the kidney using a hollow tube. Through the hollow tube, you can pass a nephroscope. Nephroscope is nothing but an endoscope where you can see the stone through your eyes, through the camera, and you can make the stone into smaller bits. You can remove them. Once you remove the stone, leave a tube in the urinary tract. If necessary, you leave a tube in the back. These patients who stay in the hospital for a day or two, they are advised rest for a week or two. Patients with stone disease in the urinary tract most often managed if the stones are less than 6 mm to 7 mm by medication. If they are beyond that, through endoscopic method using holmium laser, the stones are broken and they go back home on the same day or the following day. These patients, no need for them to stay in the at home. They can go back to work from the day they get discharged or the following day. Stones in the urinary bladder are uncommon nowadays. If they are present, you will have to identify the cause and treat the cause along with treating the stone disease. And patients who have stone problem, they not only need treatment for the stone disease, they need to identify why they formed stones. So patients who are first time stone former, they need stone treatment. They are advised to come periodically and they are monitored with some potassium magnesium citrate to see whether they form stone again. If they form stone again, they need to be evaluated thoroughly. There are certain group of people come to us with the recurrent stone disease. Most of them, even though we are not able to identify any cause, they don't follow the advice given by the doctors and they don't follow the method of advice related to medication, related to food taken, related to checkup. This is the common problem we face with the patients. The other patients who are forming recurrent stone problem, there will be some congenital problem, some metabolic problem which need to be corrected by doing extensive blood test. The ideal way to prevent stone problem at present scenario is to drink enough water to produce urine at least 2 liters a day and taking less salty food, avoiding excess non-vegetarian food, avoiding food which has got high salt in our daily diet like pickles, papad, dry fish, which are really not advisable. So having a healthy food, keeping a vegetarian diet, drinking plenty of water, most often prevents stone problem. Thank you.